some comfy ass beds, man. Alright. It's good?
Good,
man. What's up, baby? Esto sabe quién es Mauricio Molina, Pretty Boy Mo, Washington, D.C. Aquí tengo a un dominicano que está pegando.
Dominicano en Paris.
Él se llama Sensato. What's up, Sensato? Sensato, ¿qué es lo que hay, baby? What's up?
Chilling. Just got back from L.A. Here in Washington, D.C. Vamos a estar hoy en Love Nightclub with my boy Toby Love. No vaina bien.
Sí, y está un poquito ronco.
Oh, sí, yeah. I was in L.A. for the whole week.
Calibas, right? Yeah, ¿cómo estuvo Calibas, man?
Awesome. Estábamos en el Staples Center.
¿Cómo cuánta gente?
Yes, over like 17,000 people.
Wow.
Crazy, yeah.
Y eso fue like your first time in Calibas, right?
I've been there. Yo estaba allí el año pasado con Pitbull, pero, you know, as an invited artist. But now I got...
That's an artist, official artist.
No, I was in the lineup.
Okay, y ya siendo el 2012, ¿cuántos años tú llevas ya en tu carrera de rapero, de cantante, de dembow, todo eso? ¿Cuántos años tú llevas?
Como 8 años.
¿8 años? Oh,
it's more than that, but yo digo 8 porque en verdad, you know, así, en serio, pero I've been doing it for a while, you know, since I was little.
Ah, pues hace 10 años, ¿qué estabas haciendo tú hace 10 años from today?
Yo estaba en República Dominicana, grinding.
Grinding. Records, demos, and rapping, and hace 8 años cuando comenzaste, ¿tú te imaginabas de que ibas a cantar con un latino que está pegando no solo con la gente latina, pero también está pegando con los morenos, con los gringos, con los chinos, Pitbull? Like, did it ever cross your mind that you're gonna be singing with Pitbull, man?
I mean,
or like someone that big in the moment. I mean,
I don't know, man.
It must be huge,
yeah,
bro.
It was a blessing, bro. It was just a blessing. Like, after we did the Watagata Brutus Berry, the track was... Sorry about that. The track was... the track blew up without Pitbull, you know?
Yeah.
The Watagata Brutus Berry.
And the remix.
But then we did the remix with Pitbull. That's when I met him.
Yeah.
And he, from the get-go, he was already like... He's like, yo, no way, I'm gonna get Lil Jon on it. Like, you know, like, he was already... From day one, he was already on his helping.
Yeah.
You know? So, that's pretty much how we began. You know, I met him there, we did that, the track was crazy. And then I kept the relationship. He would invite me here and there, some events. You know, if he was to go to New York, he'll call me, yo, I'm in New York, dale para allá. I'll go with Miami, same thing. And, you know, now we got the Latinos in Paris that we just threw that out.
Whose idea was that?
That was mine, my idea. I shouldn't say my idea, but we was on the tour bus. Estábamos en la guagua. With, you know, on Pitbull's tour, and I'm listening to the beat, and I'm riding to it, and then he stops and he listens to me. He's like, yo, what you doing? You doing this? You okay? And the next day, he already had it recorded.
Wow.
The next day, in the bus,
he's like,
yo, look, listen, and he takes out his
little boombox.
Yeah, his boombox, put this fucking BlackBerry on, pop, and plays, and it was already recorded.
Wow. And that video was shot in Paris too.
Yeah, he had an event over there. He had a big event, it's called Star Floor.
Es
un evento de la radio, que así como un megatón, like,
a
radio event. And
a radio event.
So he was like, yo, I'm gonna be in Paris, you wanna come? But we took a plane to Paris, and then we ended up shooting the video right in Paris, just fucking around.
Yeah, like on stage and everything.
On stage, you know, walking around the Eiffel Tower.
Man, I'm like, just a question, when people do a remix like that, like, cause like I'm in the radio and I always wanted to ask somebody, do you have to ask permission to do a remix like that? Like, for example, like, do you have to call Jay-Z or Kanye to be like, yo, I'm doing a remix to your same logo beat type thing?
Yeah, well, when you on pitch level, all that stuff is kind of like managed.
It's already.
But I kind of
figure that too.
Yeah,
so.
but you know, and as to tell you something about that, but that question, it doesn't really matter if you do remixes to whatever, you know what I'm saying? As long as you're not selling and making money out of it.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Because, of course, if I put the track on iTunes,
and
the producer, you know, then that's when that
everybody
kicks in.
Makes money out of it.
Pero I could do a remix of La Cucaracha, and nobody could do nothing to me, you know what I'm saying?
But I mean, now it's just like social networks promo, like a song promo, YouTube.
Yeah, and that's the way the hip-hop works, and it has worked like that forever, like the English hip-hop.
Yeah.
You know, they always done remixes to everything.
Yeah.
Like, hip-hop is all remixes of everything. It's like old school records, you know? So it's like, you know, once, but when you want to sell it, that's when you gotta get the
How much And in what way has your life changed ever since you became an artist, like global artist, like known, I mean, PR or the US and now in Paris? I mean, is it a good life, meaning like the money wise and like being famous wise? Like, what's it like being famous?
I'm on my grind, you know, even though I got a buzz, I don't consider myself like a big thing, you know.
Humble right here, man.
Like I'm saying, you know, because it's true, you know, so I'm still on my grind. Now, my life has changed, okay, ya no es igual.
Sí.
Tú sabes, la gente te conoce, tú no puedes hacer lo mismo de antes.
La mujer, los groupies.
Ajá, it's like a whole package, you know?
Yeah.
But it's not something that you can't handle. You
yeah.
know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Eso es lo que, this is what I love to do, so mm-hmm. I know it's part of my job, you know what I'm saying? So, it's like, you know, it's gonna get worse.
Yeah.
Pero so far, so good, you know?
Así que si no estuvieras cantando, rapeando, ¿qué estuvieras haciendo? ¿Trabajando de qué y trabajando a dónde?
Bueno.
Be honest.
En la calle.
En la calle. ¿Vendiendo en la calle?
Most likely.
Yeah, you know, it's an honest dude right here,
that's
man.
That's why, you know, yeah, I keep it real, you know.
Cool. Probably,
I mean, but, you know, eso no es, yo no soy ese tipo de persona.
Yeah.
I want every, you know, mi consejo para cualquier teenager, yeah. cualquier adolescente, you know, to stay in school and do their thing, you know, go to college, get the degree, you know. But if you want to play baseball, you want to be a rapper, then go hard, you know, go for it. If you love it.
Single? Married?
Yeah. Oh, single? No, I'm single.
Single.
I thought you meant single, like my single. You're single.
Soltero
y sin compromiso.
Sí, soltero y sin compromiso.
Single, ready to mingle.
¿Qué tipo de mujeres te gustan? Morenitas, blancas, rubias, pelo negro, colochas.
Man. Depende how I feel, man.
Big butt girls.
All type of girls, man.
Are you an ass man or a titty man?
I'm an ass and titty man.
Ass? Oh, hell. You want the combo.
Yeah, no, but I me gusta la mujer latina.
Latina.
Claro, you know. I love Latina girls.
Cool. Bueno, ya tú sabes, baby, Mauricio Molina con Sensato aquí en Washington, D.C. Y antes que me vaya, una capela de cualquier canción que tú... Like, just una capela. Give me some.
Bueno, esto es lo nuevo, Crazy People featuring Pitbull. Este es mi nuevo sencillo. Y dice, locas y locos. Locas con bocas grandes que bobo. ¿Cómo? No, yo no sé cómo, pero ella se comió la banana como un mono.
Ah.
Sensato, catch that, Crazy People. Go get that.